Fire's been on the landscape for tens of thousands of years. The fire itself isn't bad, but when it runs into someone's house, it becomes a problem. The Forest Service has been doing a lot of understory fuels reduction, especially over the last 20 years. We're really trying to concentrate our efforts around values at risk, and that's, you know, property, lives, livelihoods, and to some extent, timber values. So on the Superior National Forest, there's a lot of balsam fir, which is the fuel that the fire burns. We are either cutting and chipping or cutting and piling and burning the balsam fir in the understory. That's not really a very good use of the product.
There's two things that can happen to those piles. They'll either be burned in a controlled manner or they'll just be left alone. Either way, roughly 90% of the carbon atoms that exist in those tree piles will end up as CO2 in our atmosphere over the next few decades. My name is Brian Berry. I'm the Chemistry and Material Science Program Leader at the Natural Resources Research Institute. My research has always been focused on the environment. This balsam fir that's being removed in the forest, we want to collect this and convert it to biochar. Biochar is charcoal, right? But it's a fit for purpose charcoal, meaning that it was produced under specific conditions to produce specific properties in the resulting product. The primary driving factor for the growth of the biochar sector is the value of the carbon sequestration credits that you can get from producing biochar. But on top of that, biochar as a material has many beneficial properties in a lot of different applications. We're producing biochar from the balsam fir that's being removed from the forests. And then a local power company, Minnesota Power, they need to cap some of their coal ash landfills. And it's difficult to revegetate those caps. So the caps are essentially soil-based caps, and then they grow native prairie grasses, et cetera. And biochar is going to improve the revegetation efforts of these landfill caps. One of the primary benefits for this project is lowering the cost of removing balsam fir from the forest. If you can lower the cost, then you can do more of it.
When I heard about the biochar possibility, I got really excited. We're always looking for new ways to treat our balsam fir problem. There's just so much of it across the landscape. If there was some sort of market for it, that would be fantastic.
If we can find value in that material, we can lower the costs and have better managed forests. Part of our mission at NRI is to drive economic growth for our state while also being good stewards of the environment. And so this project kind of hits on both of those. One, we are providing an opportunity for the economy to grow through job development, through building a new sector, that is the biochar industry. Also, we are helping prevent the spread of forest fires. And at the same time, the production of biochar is a carbon negative technology, which lowers the concentration of carbon in our atmosphere.